So another really basic skill that you need to have is to be able to look at a differential equation and know immediately what are the dependent variables and what are the independent variables. And the reason that matters is because, as you recall, differential equations are equations for unknown functions in terms of their derivatives. And functions have inputs and an output, and you got to know what's the input and what's the output. So let me try to remind you of what I'm talking about here. You could think of a function as a box where you stick stuff in, and for every set of stuff you stick in, you get one thing out. And so, you know, if there's a function where you stick in x and y and you get out g of xy, then the x and y are the independent variables. Independent variables mean the input, and the thing you get out, the g, that's the dependent variable because it depends on x and y. Okay, so what does this have to do with differential equations? Okay, so here's the differential equation. And if you're going to solve for the unknown function, you got to figure out what is the unknown function, right? So it's always the case that the thing or things you differentiate with respect to, those are the independent variables, right? So here you're differentiating with respect to t. That means t has to be the independent variable. What's the dependent variable? Well, it's the only other one that's hanging around. It's the one that you're differentiating, which is x. So when you see this differential equation, immediately what you should think is that what you would like to do is solve this for the unknown function x of t. For this differential equation, you should look at this and say, well, there's one independent variable, x, and there's two dependent variables, y and z. So this may not be enough information, this single equation, to solve for both those quantities, but what you might hope to do with sufficient information is to solve for the functions y of x and z of x, the unknown functions. You look at this differential equation, and you see that you've differentiated with respect to two things, x and t. So those have to be independent variables, and you see one dependent variable, y, hanging around. So, you know, you might imagine that what you have to do is solve for the unknown function y, which depends on x and t. Now, this is actually an example of a partial differential equation, and we'll mostly talk about ordinary differential equations here. But this is just to give you practice being able to discern what's the dependent variable, what's the independent variable.